How do we explain the mysteries of life? Science has steadily overturned old religious myths about how all this came to be. Yet those who adhere to Judaism, Christianity, or Islam still prefer to ignore reason and have faith in their forever unprovable, omniscient creator.
From under the blue.
For example, when I became a Christian, I had a hard time obeying my parents. Seems
glory, glory,
I had thought science was rolling back religious belief, but I was wrong. Far from being beaten, militant faith is on the march all across the world, with terrifying consequences. As a scientist, I'm increasingly worried about how faith is undermining science. It's something we must resist, because irrational faith is feeding murderous intolerance throughout the world.
In this program, I want to examine two further problems with religion. I believe it can lead to a warped and inflexible morality, and I'm very concerned about the religious indoctrination of children.
I want to show how faith acts like a virus that attacks the young and infects generation after generation.
I believe in a lawgiver, a God right there, actually not behind it, right imminent here, right now.
I want to ask whether ancient mythology should be taught as truth in schools.
Professor Dawkins, I'm very impressed that you're the new Messiah. And I appreciate your desire to redeem the world.
It's time to question the abuse of childhood innocence with superstitious ideas of hellfire and damnation.
I would rather for them to understand that hell is a place that they absolutely do not want to go.
This one would have been a preacher. Now they'll never hear his voice.
And I want to show how the scriptural roots of the Judeo-Christian moral edifice are cruel and brutish. What in the 21st century are we doing venerating a book that contains such stuff? Science weighs up evidence and advances. Religion is hidebound belief for belief's sake. It's bad for our children, and it's bad for you. There is something exceedingly odd about the idea of sectarian religious schools. If we hadn't got used to it over the centuries, we'd find it downright bizarre. Sectarian education has proved to be deeply damaging. It has left a terrible legacy. When you think about it, isn't it weird the way we automatically label a tiny child with its parents' religion?
These are Jewish children. In another part of Jerusalem, we've seen Muslim children. In Northern Ireland, we have Catholic children, Protestant children, all going to separate schools.
But what's so special about religion that it is allowed to label small children, Catholic or Protestant, Jewish or Muslim? Nobody would categorize children by the political party their parents support, call them Tory or Labour children. We agree they're too young to know where they stand on questions of politics. So why is it not the same for where they stand on the cosmos and humanity's place in it?
In genetic evolution, a species divides into two, initially geographically. There's some initial separation between the two subspecies, and they divide away from each other genetically. There's no longer gene flow between them, and so they can become separate species. It's a divisive force.
Sectarian education acts in a similar way. Children are initially isolated from each other because of their parents' faith. Then their differences are constantly drilled into them, and they embark on opposing life trajectories. Such divisions are encouraged, not just in faraway Israel, but right on our doorstep, in Northern Ireland, for instance, or in London. In North London, the Hasidic Jewish community is the largest after Israel and New York. Here, religious division is taken to its extreme. These ultra-Orthodox Jews only marry within their sect. Television is frowned upon, and of course children attend exclusive religious schools, cloistered away from external influences, which just might persuade them to look outside their community. I want to find out why these children are being segregated and whether their culture allows them to open their minds to reality.
Hello? Hello.
Rabbi Gluck.
Nice to meet you.
I'm Richard Dawkins. How do you do?
Thanks, but fine. Nice to meet you. Please come in.
Good, thank you very much.
Rabbi Gluck is London-born and bred, but you wouldn't necessarily know it. His accent is a testament to the isolation of this religious sect. Why should children be victims of the particular tradition in which they happen to have been born, rather than choosing for themselves by being shown all the evidence that's available?
We are all, to a certain extent, affected by our surroundings. There's no such thing as a person living in a vacuum.
Indeed.
We're all affected by our parents, by our family.
Yes.
But at the same time, we have a choice to stay or otherwise. I think it's important for a minority to be able to have a space where it can express itself, where it can learn about itself.
Well, couldn't you preserve the customs, the traditions, the history, without somehow imposing upon the children views about the universe which modern science would say are simply false?
I would say impose upon a Jew anything. I would say that's something which is impossible. I think scientifically impossible. We believe that God created the world in 6 days. We know about evolution. Every single Jewish kid knows about evolution and has thought about it and has studied it and has looked at it and has thought, what's going on here?
How many of the children who come up through your system, your school system, end up believing in evolution?
I think that the majority don't believe in evolution. But at the same time, it isn't they don't believe because they don't know about it.
You realise they're being taught that the entire world began after what archaeologists would recognise as the agricultural revolution. I mean, these children are being brought up in a very distorted world indeed. I worry about children being victims of this kind of what I can only describe as miseducation.
I find the terms as distorted and miseducation rather disturbing. Judaism has its tradition. I think there are various scientists who have their tradition. It's still called the theory of evolution.
Well, it's called that, but that's in a very technical sense.
But still, it's called that. And it's not called the law of evolution.
Well, I will call it the fact of evolution.
You're a fundamentalist believer.
No, I'm not a fundamentalist believer. The age of the Earth, 5,000 years. I mean, I'm sorry, Rabbi, that is ridiculous. Of course, Rabbi Gluck is right that it's important for us to learn about our own background. But what upsets me is that in pursuit of that, these innocent children are being saddled with demonstrable falsehoods. And this is not just a problem of the Jewish minority. There's pressure from an increasing number of faith schools of other religions to put scientific fact on a par with primitive creation myths. In science classes, why can't they simply teach science?
You say this is truth because it's based on evidence. That's
such a
funny
answer.
Well, no,
you don't exactly say that. You say we're struggling towards the truth, and as new evidence comes in, we refine it.